knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
For some time now, we've been working our way through the clade Ecdysozoa, and more recently, the phylum Arthropoda. It's now time to wrap up our study of these two clades by examining the last remaining subphylum of Arthropoda, which is Hexapoda. This contains all the insects in the world, so it's a very large clade, and it will take a few tutorials to get through it, but let's get started. More modern analyses have placed Hexapoda as a class of pancrustacea, closely related to Remipedia, within the clade Labiocharida. Traditionally, it was considered one of the five major arthropod subphyla, and is often still described as such in many zoology books. They are some of the most familiar invertebrates, and they have a long history of helping or hurting humanity. Some, like the pollinators, detritivores, and predaceous insects, are often considered essential to human life on Earth. Others, like the mosquitoes, are responsible for carrying diseases such as malaria, which causes over 250 million hospitalizations and around 500,000 deaths annually. The name Hexapoda translates into six legs, and the largest hexapodan clade are the insects, whose name is derived directly from the Latin insectum. Combined, they are more numerous, biodiverse, and collectively heavier than all the terrestrial vertebrates on the planet. To put this into perspective, the total biomass of all insects consumed by spiders is around 400 to 800 million tons, which is more than double the total biomass of humanity. And remember, that's just the insect biomass that the spiders eat. In this tutorial, we will focus on the clade Insecta, also called Ectognatha. Insects are, like all arthropods, segmented, bilaterally symmetrical ecdysozoans with jointed appendages and an open circulatory system that makes use of a hemocoele. However, they are easily distinguished from the other arthropods due to their three-part body that is generally made up of a head, thorax, and abdomen, their three pairs of jointed legs, compound eyes, and single pair of antennae. Here we will focus on insect external and internal anatomy. Insect external anatomy is much more homogeneous in tagmatization than the crustaceans. Insect tagmata generally includes the head, thorax, and abdomen, but in some species, like many hymenopterans, the three main segments are the head, the mesosoma, which is the thorax and the first segment of the abdomen, and the metasoma. The head is located at the front of the insect and contains the sensory organs, such as the antennae, compound eyes, three ocelli, palps, clypeus, and mouth. Insect mouths generally vary between four main uses: chewing or biting, siphoning, piercing, or sponging. Chewing mouthparts are used, for example, by grasshoppers, beetles, ants, and mantids to bite off and chew plant material or prey. The mandibles of these insects are typically strong and adapted for cutting and grinding. Siphoning mouthparts are found in moths and butterflies. These insects have long tubular mouthparts that are used to suck nectar from flowers. Piercing mouthparts are found in mosquitoes and fleas. These insects use long, needle-like mouthparts to pierce the skin of their host and suck blood or other fluids. Sponging mouthparts are found in insects such as houseflies. They have a pair of large lobes with grooves used to lap at liquid or expel digestive enzymes to liquefy food. Some insects may have more than one mouth type. For example, horseflies have primarily sponging mouthparts in addition to mandibles they use to pierce flesh first before sponging up fluids. Moving posteriorly, the thorax is generally made up of the prothorax, mesothorax, and metathorax, and each bears a pair of legs. The forelegs attach to the prothorax, the midlegs attach to the mesothorax, and the hind legs attach to the metathorax. Insect legs are typically broken down into the coxa, where the legs meet the abdomen, trochanter, femur, tibia, and tarsus. the individual parts of the tarsi are known as tarsomeres, and they end in tarsal claws, which may be highly modified. Most insects also bear a pair of wings on both the mesothorax and metathorax. The first pair of wings are known as the forewings, and the second pair of wings are known as the hind wings. Insects, the only invertebrates capable of flying, evolved flight much earlier than the vertebrates. They accomplish it through direct and/or indirect flight muscles. In some species, like the dragonflies and mayflies, flight muscles attach directly to the wings and are neuronally controlled by a synchronous system where the nervous system stimulates a single muscle contraction and thus a single wing stroke. Other insects, like the flies, beetles, and hymenopterans, which include bees and wasps, use an asynchronous system to activate an extremely high wing beat using indirect flight muscles to oscillate the thorax. The legs and wings of insects vary greatly depending on lifestyle. For example, a grasshopper has long, strong legs adapted for jumping, while a praying mantis has long, spiny legs adapted for grasping prey, and the limbs of many termites are nearly uniform. The wings of insects are also adapted for their specific lifestyle, with some insects having wings that are transparent and delicate, while others have forewings that are thick and protective, called an elytra in the beetles. Dipterans, or the flies, have only the forewings, as the hind wings have been reduced to tiny club-like structures known as halters, which vibrate and maintain equilibrium in flight. Lastly, the abdomen contains the majority of the digestive, reproductive, and excretory systems. It is comprised of 9 to 11 segments whose dorsal ends are known as tergites, which often contain spiracles, and ventral ends are known as sternites. The 11th segment, when present, often houses a pair of cerci. The genital openings often emerge from segments 8 and 9. Females of many species also have an ovipositor, used to deposit eggs. The hymenopteran stinger of many wasps and bees is actually just a modified ovipositor. Now moving from external anatomy to internal anatomy, most insects have complete digestive, excretory, muscular, circulatory, tracheal, endocrine, nervous, and reproductive systems. The insect digestive system is comprised of a long enclosed tube known as an alimentary canal, which runs the length of the body. This canal is made of three parts. The first is the foregut, which includes the mouth, pharynx, and esophagus. Digestion begins in the buccal cavity, or externally in the case of the sponging mouthparts. Food is mixed with saliva and pumped into the pharynx, which passes food to the esophagus, which passes food directly to the midgut, or the crop and proventriculus for further grinding, or the fluid-filled diverticulum in flies. The majority of digestion often takes place within the midgut, where microvilli allow for increased surface area and absorption. Finally, undigested food passes into the hindgut, where it is joined by uric acid from the excretory system to form fecal pellets. The rectum reabsorbs water from the pellets, and the mostly dry pellets are expelled through the anus. However, some species, like the leaf-mining and plant sap-feeding aphids, excrete sugar-rich honeydew instead, which may be harvested by ants, who essentially farm the substance. The insect excretory system may consist of one to many hundreds of Malpighian tubules that remove nitrogenous waste from the hemolymph and regulate osmotic balance. This joins directly with the digestive system. The muscular system of insects ranges from a few hundred muscles to a few thousand. Unlike vertebrates that have both smooth and striated muscles, insects have only striated muscles. Muscle cells are amassed into muscle fibers and then into the functional unit, the muscle. These muscles are attached to the body wall, with attachment fibers running through the cuticle and to the epicuticle, where they can move different parts of the body, including appendages such as wings. The insect open circulatory system consists of a tubular dorsal heart that pumps hemolymph through the dorsal aorta. Once released, secondary pulsatory organs push the hemolymph throughout the body. The hemolymph transports nutrients, wastes, hormones, and immune cells, though unlike vertebrate blood, it plays very little role in oxygen transport and gas exchange. Insects accomplish gas exchange through their tracheal system, which is an extensive network of thin-walled tubes that branch into every part of the body and delivers oxygen directly to individual cells through the fluid-filled tracheoles. Oxygen is brought into the system, and carbon dioxide is released through tiny openings called spiracles, which are located along the abdomen and thorax. The system sometimes includes air sacs. Some very small insects exchange gases entirely through diffusion, and many larval forms of terrestrial insects, such as the nymphs of stoneflies and mayflies, have tracheal gills, which are thin extensions of the tracheal system, while dragonfly nymphs have rectal gills. Others, like larval mosquitoes, have a tiny snorkel that extends from the rectum, while still others, like the diving beetles and water scorpions, trap a layer of air against their bodies, allowing for passive diffusion of oxygen and carbon dioxide with the surrounding water. The insect endocrine, or hormonal system, works in conjunction with the circulatory system as the hemolymph carries hormones that are produced by glandular and neuronal organs, which play a role in reproduction, metamorphosis, molting, dormancy, and other behaviors. The insect nervous system is essentially split between the central nervous system, peripheral nervous system, and sensory organs. The central nervous system consists of a three-lobed brain and ventral nerve cord. The peripheral nervous system consists of motor neurons and sensory neurons that detect environmental stimuli through the sensory organs. Insects have a wide range of sensory organs. Most adults have two types of eyes, simple and compound. The simple eyes of most insects take the form of three ocelli at the top of their head that are especially adapted to monitor light intensity and photoperiods. The compound eyes, meanwhile, are made up of thousands of individual ommatidia, up to 30,000 in some species, though some ants only have two, and most have less than 10,000. These individual ommatidia can distinguish 200 to 300 individual flashes of light each second, far greater than humans, who often can only distinguish between 45 and 55 frames per second, so to speak. Many species are capable of seeing in the ultraviolet spectrum, but not red, which is invisible to insects, much like how ultraviolet is invisible to us. In addition, insects are capable of receiving mechanical stimuli through sensilla, which range from an individual setae, or hair-like projection attached to nerve cells, or more complex organs such as chordotonal organs, or stretch organs, located in the joints. Setae capable of receiving mechanical reception are widely distributed throughout the body, legs, and especially antennae. Insects can also detect auditory signals through different setae, or through the tympanal organs that are most common in orthopterans like grasshoppers and crickets, hemipterans, and lepidopterans. Insects are also capable of chemoreception, meaning taste or smell, mainly through sensory cells around the mouths, but also dispersed through the tarsal organs on the legs, wings, and antennae. The number and location of chemosensory cells differs greatly by species. In addition, insects also have nociceptor or pain receptors scattered throughout their bodies, and many species can also sense temperature, humidity, and gravity. Finally, most insects are dioecious with corresponding reproductive systems, but we will cover that in the next tutorial where we examine the life cycle and behavior of insects.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.